let's go ahead and change the boot animation because most of the time I do not like the boot animation that comes with things. This is the dancing droids animation that comes default with these devices. I'm going to show you how to change it, and it'll probably work for other devices as well, not just the Rockchip MTCE devices. We're going to open up a root browser. I'm using the one by Jimmy Rumi. You can use whichever one that you prefer. And we're going to go and find the boot animation we're trying to change it with. And copy it. Now I have already changed the boot animation name to the name of the one in the folder here, which is essential to this method. So you can either choose bootanimation.zip or bootanimation_dancing_droids.zip, which is what I did. Now either rename the original one to .back, or you can delete it. But do not try to copy over it, because that often results in a zero size storage for that boot animation, and that will not work at all. Go ahead and paste the boot animation you want to install in there, and then click on it. Go to Properties, and we're going to change permissions to what I'm putting here, which is a read-write-rr-644, and this is very essential to the whole process. Reboot, and there you go. Enjoy this one while it lasts, because Top John Woo, who creates Magist, has decided not to continue with Mask Hide anymore due to a conflict with him working at Google now. So let's go into Terminal Emulator and type a couple commands so we can do wireless ADB. I'll leave the commands in the description so you can just copy and paste if you look at them from there. Now we're going to find our IP address and network under the Wi-Fi we're connected to. Then we're going to click ADB Connect that IP address. Now we're going to push over Safety Net Fix by KDragon. Now you can copy this from a flash drive or something if you don't want to do it over wireless, but I prefer to do it over wireless. If we check safety net, you can tell that it's not passing. We're going to go to settings and turn on Magist Hide. And then we're going to hide the Magist app. We're going to go into Magist and click on the puzzle piece. Then scroll down and find Magist Hide Props Config and install it. We're going to go to Install from Storage and select the Safety Net Fix by KDragon. Now this is maybe not necessary. I just kind of did trial and error here. You might can just use the Mask Hide or Magist Hide props config and what I do later, and it might still work. So
safety net is still failing, so we're going to try some other things. Let's search for BusyBox and install it. Let's click on the shield and let's click on mask hide. Now hide any app that you might think would interfere with safety net, such as Google and banking, any of that kind of apps, streaming services as well. Since it's still failing, let's go to the Play Store and install Termix. We're going to type SU, grant, then we're going to type props. We're going to change the device fingerprint, so select 1, then select F. And I'm going to go with Google, so let's select 7. And I'm going to use the props for the Pixel 4 XL, which is number 23. So select whichever one you plan to use. Make sure to select Android 10 since we're on Android 10. Type a Y and enter. Now type N to not reboot. And let's go back and type props again. Now it will pass. Here's how you easily update a gist on HAL9K Mod 5. Open the gist. Select update. Click allow. Select direct install. And then let's go. And it'll just start installing. After that, click reboot. And that's it. That's all you have to do. This is the only ROM that I know that this works on, the Android 10 version of it.